Blender tutorial, rotating a duplicate around a central point using the array modifier. Delete that. Oops, delete that. I don't want it. Add an empty. Yes, my cursor's already in the center. Just confirm. We already, because I just started it. Okay, so add a mesh, cube. There we go. Modifiers over here. Add modifier array. I want 12 of them. Okay, deselect that, add that, and my offset is empty, which is in the middle. Now to move, I need to move it, so I'll put it into edit mode. Have everything selected, G, X to move it across the X axis. Go back to empty. Now rotate on the Z axis, and that gives me that. I can rotate on the Y axis, X, but I want Z. Okay, there we go. Now if I want to change that cube, it's kind of problematic, because if I change the size, it sort of warps everything. And if I rotate, it kind of warps as well. If I move anything, it kind of like goes a little bit mental as well. So what I do is go to edit mode, and I just change just the individual box, so I can change the size. There we go, and the circle is maintained. I can change the rotation, and the circle is maintained, and I can change the placement, and the circle is maintained. If I want to make that a little more complicated, I can stay in edit mode and add a monkey. I'll make the monkey a bit higher, move it across the X axis, put it on top of the plinth, and I need to rotate it so it faces the center. I'm just going to put that into Z mode, 7, so I can fine tune it. GX and rotate Z. There we go. I'm going to bring it in a bit. Oh god, there. And bring it down so signal on. So GZ. Got it. Finally. There we go. That's good. Object, once again, I can't really change the size, shape, or location without kind of really affecting everything. So what I can do is go into object, edit mode again, yes. I can select all, and I can move it all around and maintain the circle if I want to. Another way of doing it is to apply the modifier. Bang! Now it's one massive object, and now I can move it around like that, resize it, and even rotate it like that. So that's pretty good. Hopefully that is pretty clear. Now what I'm going to do is just spend a few more moments having a bit of fun with it by creating a texture for it, smoothing it out. New image or movie, open the file, which is down here. There we go. And alright, I've also got to be in a some other mode, like GLSL. There we go. Reflection. There we go. Not a very good one. so I'll use something else. Let's have a look at the previews. That one there. There we go. Oh, still not very good, is it? But they look pretty shiny. Let's add a mesh, like a carpet. Make it an image, and I'll make it a green felt. There we go. Even that's not very good. Golly. Whatever. See you later.